InternetQ is a London-listed mobile marketing firm that has just come through with its full-year numbers. It's seen revenues up 47%, it's got EBITDA up almost 60%, and all this as a 15% drop in operating expenditure per employee has also come through in these numbers. Panos Dimitropoulos is the Chief Executive Officer, and he joins us now with some more. Panos, welcome. These are interesting numbers. Explain exactly how you've done this.
Well, we keep investing in our business, we keep growing and expanding, not only in terms of geographies, but also in terms of new product development and new ideas and innovation.
Are these numbers, sort of numbers, repeatable?
Well, I mean, we've proven so far, like 10 years now, that we are not only profitable, but we also keep growing. So our aggregate growth the last 4 or 5 years has been around 47%. And we expect this to continue and even extend further.
Just in terms of where you are, you mentioned very briefly about the geographies. Explain a little bit more about where your business is globally.
Yeah, we started out from Greece, but then we expanded to Eastern Europe and Russia, and then to Middle East and Turkey. After that, we made an acquisition in Southeast Asia, so we expanded actually in the region, the footprint of the company that we acquired, and we are not doing business not only we're not doing business only in the places in the countries that we have offices, but we also do business in 50 plus other countries all around the world. So we've done business in Africa, in Latin America, in Southern Europe, in Northern Africa.
And is your strategy to grow by acquisition as you've done in the past, or is it a mixture of acquisition and organic growth?
Well, actually, I mean, I guess the target of any company would be to combine both. I mean, the optimal thing would be just to continue growing by having organic growth, a steady organic growth of 40% plus. But still, we need to look into an acquisition strategy, just to not only to implement our business, but also to expand in terms of geographies and, you know, just to have a shortcut in our strategy.
Let's talk a little bit more about exactly how the business is structured and how you do make money. What is the basic platform that you operate which enables you to turn a profit?
Yeah, first of all, our business is mainly across two lines. One is the plain vanilla mobile marketing services that we offer to operators, and the other is the mobile music streaming platform, which is a product that we also offer to the operators. So in other words, our customers are mainly the operators, are approximately around 90%. And what we do is that we have, from one side, mobile marketing services that are actually serving our customers, the operators, by trying to, let's say, enhance their products and deliver the right message to the end user, the subscriber, and at the same time we use our mobile streaming service as a content offering to our customers, the operators. So the challenge here is to be able to combine both.
So as a user of a smartphone, I would only come into contact with your software through my operator, and my operator would use your services to deliver to me marketing material?
Exactly, marketing material. The operator would use our mobile marketing platform in order to advertise a new data plan, bundling service, a new application, or any product that you can imagine. That would be a way to drive ARPU higher and extend the customer base. And at the same time, as I said, through our mobile marketing experience and expertise, we push the mobile music platform, which is the Akazoo. It is a content service that we offer mainly to operators.
And competitors in that space being
Spotify, Deezer, Simfy.
What sort of money are you spending to keep ahead of the game? Because clearly this technology changes all the time.
Well, I mean, we invest a lot, but not so much as to, how can I say, burn a lot of cash, because we claim that we are not a cash-burning company. Mm-hmm. We have the best cash burn rate among the other competitors in the industry. So we spend approximately in capital expenditures and software acquisition around like 6 or 7 million per year.
Mm. And all that cash that you have on the balance sheet will be used to invest in the business. None of that's going back to investors.
Not yet.
Not yet. So let's take a look at the pipeline of business. Where is the company going? What milestones should investors watch out for from this point?
I would say that we have a lot of challenges ahead. One of the big challenges is to be able to expand on the field of the mobile music. I think this is a very promising sector. It's quite a hot topic nowadays. It is a service that we want to push not only to the operators but also to the device manufacturers or the broadband companies, the broadband operators. We are currently participating in two or three big RFPs that are group deals. Mm-hmm. So in other words, if we get one or two RFPs, then we'll probably have our mobile streaming service implemented in 8 or 9 countries at the same time. So I would say that it would be a challenge and a game changer for us. Hmm. We would be a comparable company, not only in terms of service, but also in terms of valuation with Spotify or Deezer or these guys there. Hmm. Although they're private and we're public, still I would say that we are highly undervalued.
Okay, well, we look forward to the news as it comes through. But Panos, in the meantime, thanks for joining us. That's the business for InternetQ and the Chief Executive, Panos Dimitropoulos.